Hello everyone, today we are going to start with our next topic, that is DOCSIS 3.1. Now we start with introduction. First is DOCSIS definition. Cable has developed DOCSIS technology to transfer data over coaxial cable that are deployed and used for cable TV connection. DOCSIS standards are adopted by the cable operators across the world so that internet data, voice and video services are provided using existing cable TV systems. Next is history. Now we start with DOCSIS 1.0. It is released in March 1997. It begins the transfer of data over cable system interface. It supports high-speed data over HFC had been defined in this DOCSIS 1.0. DOCSIS 1.1. It is released in April 1999. The state-of-art QoS techniques had been added for priority services. Next is DOCSIS 2.0. It is released in December 2001. Increased modulation format for upstream to get more bits per second per hertz. For upstream synchronous code division multiple access, new physical layer had been added. A state-of-art advanced media access control layer had been added. Allocation of two-dimensional upstream bandwidth and simultaneous transmission within the same channel had been enabled for quality of service and quality of experience. Next is DOCSIS 3.0. It was released in August 2006. Addition of IPv6 and multicast quality of service. It enables channel bonding. Old modulation formats and FEC had been kept. Next is DOCSIS 3.1. Released in October 2013. Backward compatibility has enabled. It avoids tax on spectrum. DOCSIS MAC is leveraged across legacy signal, carrier physical and non-OFDM physical. SCQAM and OFDM are enabled to share a bonding group. There is increase in capacity of data rate. Downstream capacity of 10 plus Gbps has enabled. Upstream capacity of 1 plus Gbps has enabled. The maximum is unbounded. This table shows the DOCSIS speed comparison of DOCSIS 1.x, 2.0, 3.0, 3.1 and full duplex DOCSIS 3.1. Next is DOCSIS 3.1 goals. Increased spectral efficiency, increased data rates, different spectrum and plant conditions may be adapted easily, migration from old versions of DOCSIS easily, existing HFC systems are used for operation. Next is DOCSIS 3.1 specifications. Modernization of physical layer in order to increase bits per hertz. Legacy DOCSIS PHYs plus is supported. 16384 QAM or 4096 QAM downstream and upstream modulation formats. Addition of downstream OFDMA. Addition of upstream OFDMA. Addition of error correction technology. BCH codes for outer FEC. LDPC codes for inner FEC. From DOCSIS to DOCSIS 3.1, FEC change may result in increase in gain up to two modulation orders in the same SNR environment, and gain could be close to a single order. New cable spectrum band plan has been defined, with where extension of upstream to 200 MHz, extension of downstream to 1.2 GHz or 1.7 GHz. Next is DOCSIS 3.1 key advantages. The same last mile technology, that is the coax cable, is used for supporting the higher gigabit speeds. It is a much more cost effective technology to implement for cable internet providers. A huge jump is there in download and upload internet speeds, backward compatibility, new certificate based security features are defined, the light speed sleep modes are supported during idle time. Next is full duplex DOCSIS. There is extension of DOCSIS 3.1 specifications, increased upstream capacity, symmetric multi-gigabit services are enabled over existing HFC networks, doubles the efficiency of spectrum use. Next is full duplex DOCSIS key features. First is symmetrical up or down capabilities. In full duplex communication, the upstream and downstream traffic concurrently use the same spectrum, doubling the efficiency of spectrum use. Unlike FDD, where spectrum is split between the upstream and downstream, or TDD, where spectrum is time shared between upstream and downstream traffic, full duplex communication enables upstream and downstream traffic to efficiently use the same spectrum at the same time. 10 times the upload speeds available today. Before today, maximum upload speeds of up to 1 Gbps were possible. Now, with full duplex technology, we have been able to significantly increase upload speed capabilities, which will enable very high capacity symmetrical services for residential and business services. Today, a typical broadband customer's upstream data consumption is only 10% of their downstream consumption. As new technologies and applications emerge that enable customers and their devices to share interactive high-resolution video, our networks will be prepared to support the speed and latency requirements. Next is DOCSIS 3.1 hurdles. The large chunks of spectrum are cleared for OFDM carriers, conversion to all digital carriers by eliminating analogs, new requirements for completely new standard, the testing and system monitoring tools are also new, frequency extensions and mid-splits. When downstream is extended to 1.2 GHz, there is MOCA interference. So this is all in this lecture. Thanks.